chips. All my records go hard, it's a champion hit. Yeah. I've been working for this moment like I've been in the gym. Jumping all over hurdles, I'm evading the pit. Tend to hit with anybody, take them, I can shake them. I invite them to the fire, then I bake them, I'ma break them. I'm a Hall of Fame legend, they should go and hang my jersey. Made to put in work, I don't think they really heard me like. Move the chains, I'm about to make a play. Move the chains, tell them get about the way. Move the chains, I'm about to win the game. Move the chains, baby, tell them move the chains. Ain't no stopping me, ain't no topping me, I am up. Number one seed, ain't nobody popping up. Got a squad of gorillas from the jungle suited up. You kicking off against me, hope you ready, get it up. Up, popping out a sprinter or a truck. Whole team chasing bags while they chasing us. Start an audible, I read the game, I think it's time to switch. You get hit, if I miss, then my teammates got the blitz, yeah. Move the chains, I'm about to make a play. Move the chains, tell them get about the way. Move the chains, I'm about to win the game. Move the chains, baby, tell them move the chains.
S-T-R-O. Yeah.
How many of y'all came to win?
Oh, they asking my name, huh?
Ready?
S-T-R-O, I ain't come to play with you.
Yeah.
Life challenging, but I wouldn't trade with you.
Trade.
It's early, I'm up.
Yeah.
I can't spend the day with you. I'm out of my business. I ain't getting paid with you.
Nope.
My color bright.
Yeah.
I ain't finna fade with you. Man, I gotta come clean like I'm made with you.
Clean.
I been on my everybody drop when I drop.
Yeah.
Lookin' shorty, she support, bruh. Lifting up. Never not on my grind. New York City time. Another brother better, you will never find. I've been in my bag like groceries. Competition shouldn't take shots, take notes, please. Reporting live from the winner's side. Ready try, keep a different vibe. Is you down the ride, never tie. You will never know, you ain't never tried. Work it out, hit the gym, hit the field.
Hey, yo, I need that. Big chips, man, I need that. Hustle hard. On the job, you can see that. On my head is real good, we don't need your feedback. They clear the way with my crew coming through. What I do?
Lace up the shoes, taste up the greens.
What I do?
Lace up the shoes, taste up the greens.
Now what I do?
Lace up the shoes, taste up the greens.
Yeah.
The beats, leave it in the street. Trace on the news.
What I do? Lace up my shoes, chase W's. Great colored coupes. Oh no, no, I can't be number two. MVP the league, most valuable. They sweet as apple juice. Talking trophies, I didn't grab if you can't match this attitude. I wear my heart on my sleeve, please. I move like the wind, can't catch this breeze, freeze. Stop you in your tracks, there's not no preseason. We seeking W's like Tupac used to throw up. Forget it, might as well forfeit your team, shouldn't even show up. What you wanna be when you grow up? They used to ask me. Naturally, I chose an athlete. Competition never matched me. We ain't go together. Like camouflage and polka dots. Focus on your position, just know your spot. Sure, don't stop, it's a long season. They planning on winning for the wrong reasons. Trying to get my number retired, can't let these frauds beat us. I figured out the recipe. Never let opponents get the best of me. I'm focused on my
name. Big chips, man, I need that. Hustle hard on the job, you can see that. On my head is real good, we don't need your feedback. They clear the way with my crew coming through. What I do?
Lace up the shoes, chase W's.
What I do?
Lace up the shoes, chase W's.
Now what I do?
Lace up the shoes, chase W's.
Yeah.
Leave beats, leave it in the street, case on the news.
Just a spectacular afternoon for football here in the Tar Heel State of North Carolina as EA Sports welcomes you inside Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Chicago Bears and the Carolina Panthers. Fall is in the air and the NFL season is in full swing, and we're underway here in week four. That's fielded in the end zone. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line.
That's it.
Bartender three.
They're going to need some therapy after this.
20.
On first down, it's Newton. And he's got the hook up to Moore. It's a Panthers first down, 17 yards on the play.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-arm guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. 13 yards, first down, Panthers. Well, no slow start here. A couple nice chunk plays back to back.
I love the momentum that they're showing here early because they did it both ways, right? Threw the ball on first down for a nice chunk of yardage. Came right back and ran the ball. Looks like they got the defense set back on their heels. Let's see if they can keep this moving.
A first down run, good for about three. Second and seven coming up. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it a second down.
It's a gain of five. Brings up second and five.
They're going to run the sweep. It's Samuel. He's got the first down inside the 10. And he will take it across for Panthers touchdown. Curtis Samuel, his fourth touchdown on the year. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. Extra point try good by Gano. And it's now a 7-0 game. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This will be taken short. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line.
At their own 29-yard line.
Trubisky brings the Bears up first and 10, just shy of the 30. The former Gamecock here, this is Mike Davis. And he's got a good gain of 7 up to the 37. The success there, Charles, coming on the outside of the field, the ground game. Curious to see if that continues as we progress.
Yeah, we often talk about a variety in play calling and usually between run and pass. But in this case, with strictly the run game, you can be creative there as well. Run it inside, run it outside, keep the defense off balance.
And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half, to about the 39. The good run on first down followed up by a not-so-good run on second down.
Now let's find out if they're going to stick with the run here on third down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
And Charles, a couple extra defensive backs in here on third and one.
Not expecting them to run it at all.
Now Trubisky to throw. Looks to throw, fires right side. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down. So on fourth down, on is the punter, Pat O'Donnell, to kick it away. Christian McCaffrey deep for Carolina. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the one-yard line. Amazing. Perfectly placed. If that ball goes one extra yard, maybe not even an extra yard, the starting point is the 20.
So there is a reason that a lot of punters are also excellent golfers. They know distance control. You know what else they have? Same groove motion over and over. Once they have that down, it repeats under pressure.
On second down, McCaffrey. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the 20 at the 18. That one, a first down pickup of 8. getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, looking pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
Back to throw, Newton. Being chased out left. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
I think we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
Looking to throw again on second down. Newton. Pressure, and he's taken down. A bear sack. Leonard Floyd, the old Georgia Bulldog, fighting his way into the backfield.
Two sacks last week. Another one right here. He's been unblockable lately, and I think that goes all the way back to not just his offseason, but the film study he's been doing during the week, because I think he's found matchups that he likes, and he's capitalizing.
And a few times he's even defeated double teams. He doesn't care at this point. Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete. So on fourth down, kicking it away here, Michael Pilardi. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the Bears take over. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And a three and out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out a little extra emotion. So now they get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive?
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go.
From the 44, Trubisky. There goes a deep ball. End zone. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there. Trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
I know you felt like saying touchdown there, didn't you, partner? That looked like a sure 6 points, but the contact jarred it free.
Got his hands on it, could not hold on through the end of the play. This is third and one, very likely four down territory, even if they don't get it, though. Now it's Trubisky. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Brian Burns. He's the culprit, causes a loss of five, and it brings up fourth down. O'Donnell, he's on to punt as he gets this one away. That's fielded at the 8-yard line. A very nice job on the run back there. He'll get 23 yards all told. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They've got a 7-0 lead in the football as well as they start out first and 10. The first down run not going to get them a whole lot. Maybe a yard. Yeah, it looks like just 1 yard there. So that'll bring up second and 9.
But it appeared to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
On second and 9, Newton and Thomas has it. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
And partner, I think that was a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion. But he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. Second quarter now from Charlotte, and it's the Panthers with the football. They're looking at a 3rd and 6 here to start things out.
It's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because This is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 13 yards, first down, Panthers. So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10 at the 42-yard line. They'll run with McCaffrey. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Throwing on second and 3. Newton, open man is Samuel, complete. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. 22 yards on the catch and run, a first down. On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Newton going to hand it off to McCaffrey.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through them, picking up first downs.
They'll run with Scarlett, and he is in. Touchdown, Carolina. Jordan Scarlett, his first touchdown on the year. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. And they're able to run it in. It started with the battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how are we going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
That's fielded in the end zone. And he will take it back only to about the 13-yard line here.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive, almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
And just not a ton of room to work with. He'll get it to the 15 for a gain of 2. Throwing on second and 8. Trubisky. Robinson's got it. And from the 15, they're able to work this up to the 20 for a pickup of a handful. The Panthers turn to their nickel set here as they get ready for third down. From the shotgun is Trubisky. A fight for the football, and it's intercepted. Picked off by James Bradbury. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
Boy, Brandon, that's what I'd call an ill-advised pass right there on third down. I mean, you just need a yard or two to keep the drive going. Instead, he's trying to hit a home run. You've got to really like your chances if you're going to take a shot like that.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
45.
Now following the interception, here's Newton. Trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. Picked off at about the 31. There he goes, left side. And he will score. Touchdown, Chicago. Eddie Pinheiro now for the extra point. And that one makes it 14-7. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been had he simply taken a knee. And that's the 25-yard line. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this run.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told him, they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
And is this intercepted? It is. It's intercepted. Picked off near the 42. And a terrific return as he takes this thing all the way down near the 20-yard line. That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him, that two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it, and move on. He hasn't been able to do so here in the second.
Brings up second and nine.
Draw play here. Trubisky gives to Cohen. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped to the backfield. This will be a loss of three, and now a much tougher third down looming. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
Now it's Trubisky, and this is Gabriel on the catch. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
They got the interception, but very little movement after, and that forces him to settle for three. And it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense because they ran onto the field. This is what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you got to go put out the fire, and they did, holding them to a field goal.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. 14 yards, good for a Panther first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. A shotgun snap for Newton. Cam fighting, he lost the football, it's out. They'll call it luck or skill, whatever the case is. They're feeling good about just keeping the football there.
Yeah, the biggest thing that they're calling it now, our ball. I mean, they don't care if it was luck or skill. Boy, the panic that jumps up in your chest when that ball's on the ground, whether you get it or your teammate gets it, just as long as you maintain possession, that's all you're looking for.
It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. Throwing on third down, Newton. And he's got his target. That's Moore. Touchdown, Carolina. DJ Moore. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. And that'll give them a two-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here in the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And you have to figure they won't just sit on the football here in the final minute. The way things have gone, they need to try to make something happen offensively.
But maybe they should. Maybe they should sit on it here because of what you just said. They haven't made anything happen offensively.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by James Bradbury. And they will finally stop him as he's down to the 40-yard line. Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that would look pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it.
The ball's out. McCaffrey lost it. And this is picked up by the Bears. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line. So a little under 30 seconds to go. We'll see how they play it here on first and 10. Here's Trubisky. Looking deep for Gabriel. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by Trey Boston. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Following the fumble recovery, Newton. It's caught by Davis. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. From the shotgun to McCaffrey. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Offense on third down tonight, they've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. They're looking at third and a few inches. Newton, he's going to fire one deep left sideline. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go. On now, Graham Gano. He's hit from 63 as recently as last year. And they're going to take a timeout defensively. So with fourth down coming up, they go ahead and burn it and say we'll see what happens. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. So it's halftime here in Charlotte with the Panthers out on top as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want create more hype than what is there.
But this
is a This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. 12 yards there and a first down. First down, a run with Cohen. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one?
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. On second and a yard, Trubisky. Open man, Taylor Gabriel. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8. So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 48-yard line. They'll run on first down. It's Cohen. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
180! 54! Pick me up. Here we go.
Looking to throw on second down. Trubisky, he finds Robinson. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there is they were able to connect. A little too much extracurricular there.
When you have a game with a lot of contact, tensions are going to run pretty high. You're going to be emotional, but you have to harness it somehow, and he didn't on that play.
Now Cohen, and he's going to be hemmed in and brought down right at the line of scrimmage. Dontari Poe in on the stop. They keep it on the ground. This time it's Davis. And nowhere for him to go again. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. Back-to-back stops make it 3rd and 10. Two runs for a net gain of nothing. Now here's 3rd and 10. From the gun, it's Trubisky. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And 4th down now coming up.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage. It was way too tight, unable to find anyone open.
So the drive stalls out inside the 15-yard line, but they do get 3.
And I've talked with enough players nowadays that when they have these types of kicks, that no one says to their guy, hey, that's just like making an extra point, piece of cake. Because the extra point is not a piece of cake anymore. But kicking a field goal from that distance, just give him confidence and let him knock it through.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they've got to make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put 6 on the board here. We'll see. The all-pro in 2 positions. Khalil Mack there to make the stop.
Go.
3rd and 2, Newton. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. He couldn't get the hook up there that time with Thomas.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively.
Taking it right down Broadway. Touchdown, Chicago. Tariq Cohen, his 3rd touchdown now on the year, as his guys are back within a single score.
Mike 59. Red.
Out of the gun, Trubisky, and he's got it. So the try for 2 successful, and with it, they're back within a field goal. So just a 3-point game now as they send this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
Here we go. Here we go.
1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey. Yeah, he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Now Newton. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete. So the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down. You got a young quarterback, you know, maybe that's just an example of a growing pain for him.
I think you're right about that, because when the game starts to move fast and it moves quickly on him, a lot of times they fall back on what they know best, their arm. He's slinging it on this one, had a wide open target, but didn't have the proper footwork to increase his accuracy.
Going back to Moore, this time he's got him complete. Butchwani! And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. DJ Moore with his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. Gano the extra point, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
The completion good for three, and it's second down. That first down completion only netted him three. Second and seven. Now Trubisky. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by James Bradbury. And he will score. Touchdown, Panthers. I don't know who all is to blame there, but I love seeing pick sixes.
Nothing like seeing someone pluck it out of the air and go the other way and see people try to change directions. Hard to do.
Extra point try, good by Gano. And that'll make this a three-score game now. The lead moves to 17. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And they just had that pick six. I guess the only positive maybe of them returning that for touchdown, this offense right back out onto the field to try to make up for it.
I like that because now it doesn't give them a chance to go to the bench and really settle, you know, to sit there and kind of seethe over the idea that they turned the ball over previously. Right back out there, it's almost like hopping right back on the bike after falling over. See if they can get the ball moving again.
Yeah, we'll see if they can do it here. Second and six, just inside the 30. Here's Trubisky to throw. Gets this to his running back, Tariq Cohen. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 11 yards there, first down. Trubisky now perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's first and 10. Now Trubisky to throw. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Brian Burns able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. Now this will probably be the last play of the quarter. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Well, this one from about two counties over after the sack. They come up on a second and very long. Throwing here, Trubisky. The screen pass here to Cohen. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. This will be a two-yard loss on the play. And it's going to be third down and forever.
Mike. Come on. Lock in. Mike.
Trubisky will throw. Going up top. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. picked up by James Bradberry. And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Now that turnover might just about do it here. Fourth quarter, the lead that you got, they can just run the football, run the clock.
Exactly right. They played smart, a couple of first downs, and this one should just about be over.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. From just shy of midfield, Newton, he's going to rifle one deep left side. And this is going to wind up incomplete. The coverage there too strong on the deep ball, and now they face a third down. Despite the lead here in the fourth, they're still taking shots.
Not content to sit on this lead at all. And to me, it raises the question of what's right in this game nowadays. Do you sit on the ball and run it because you have enough of a lead? Or do you try and extend it because you always feel like the other team can come back?
Extend it. Have some fun. Newton now to throw. He's going to rifle one deep left side. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. Getting a hand in there and knocking it away, Eddie Jackson.
Well, the secondary's really struggled today, but that's a little bit of a measure of revenge, isn't it? And they just followed the basic rules. See ball, knock ball away. Turned into a nice play.
Now this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. Second and 10. It's Trubisky again. That's complete to Robinson. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Going deep this time for Miller. And that'll be incomplete. Well, they took their shot all right, but it comes up empty. And it's fourth down. A critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on fourth down. They'll try and throw for it with Trubisky. Going to let one fly for Robinson. And that's caught at the 25. Touchdown, Chicago. Allen Robinson, 78 yards. And the Bears cut into that lead. Extra point safely through, and that will shave one more off this lead. So the lead back down to 10 as things get a little more interesting, and the kick is away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Well, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven.
Mike, 45.
You ain't doing no warning.
You ain't doing nothing today.
Express!
Find the mic!
Watch QB drop!
Newton to throw. Steps away to his left. He'll have a first. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And this is picked up by the Bears. And they'll set up shop right near midfield at the 49-yard line.
Partner, that one looked like it was over. I mean, they had control, had the football, and the defense had to make a play in order to keep them in the game. That's exactly what they did.
And now that door ajar, two-score game. So hold on here, not done in the fourth. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. Allen Robinson with two touchdowns on the season, both in this game, as they are now just an extra point away from making this a three-point game. Point after up and good. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Now, Charles, of course, you got to remember, last possession they fumbled, it led to a touchdown. One score game here, got to be careful.
And this is where coaching and training really comes into play, doesn't it? What does everyone say after an error? Next play, move on, next drive. That mantra has to come to the front. They've got to take care of business right here and act like the last series just didn't happen.
Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. Back to the ground on first, it's McCaffrey. And he loses the football a second time.
Wow, that ball is not free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home, the next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Watch the run, watch the run. Check 45 to Mike. Check 45 to Mike.
From the gun on third down, Newton. Oh, he almost intercepted it. They're just forcing it into too many tough spots. That was almost a fourth pick of the game. And now fourth down. Here's Michael Pilardi now. Averaging over 50 yards of punt so far as this one's away. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got to a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
If you love pressure,
we'll
see if they dial it up this drive. So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Dancing to his left. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. Opted to run for it. The decision a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble. Now it's Trubisky. He's got Burton here. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. A gain of 6 there on first. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. On the draw, this is Cohen. Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down. The Bears on third down, just one conversion in 8 tries, not good. This will be 3rd and 5. From midfield now, here's Trubisky. Finding Gabriel, complete. And he'll be brought down with the first down and a late flag here too. And he may get a few more tacked on for good measure. The penalty moves him into the red zone here on first and 10. Trubisky to throw. And he completes it to Cohen. Give him 2 yards on that play, and it'll bring up a second down. This drive, it's been a good mix. 3 passing plays, 3 runs, hitting on all 3 of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
Here's Trubisky. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Eric Reed. Well, that puts a little bit of a wrinkle in their comeback bit.
Yeah, everything had turned around for them, hadn't it? I mean, things were now going their way. But you did mention it's a wrinkle in their comeback bit. It's not the death knell for them by any stretch, but now they've got some extra work to do in order to climb all the way back.
Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts. As they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. So 2nd and 9, and you'd have to figure just about all 11 probably crashing the line here. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. Now the Bears going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game. Third down, here's McCaffrey. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about 1 yard, if that. Now the Bears will use their 3rd and final timeout as they'll stop him with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. Pilardi now on to punt as he sends this one away. That's taken on the 25. Give them 11 yards that time on the return. And that will come the offense as they take over. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision. Are you in field goal range, or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have another play.
We'll see how they handle it. So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense. 1st and 10. Back to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Trey Boston. And he will bring it out past the 20-yard line. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And they've got this one in hand. No timeouts remaining defensively, so this one should just be one kneel and then handshakes. And this one going to wrap up with Cam Newton going down to a knee. Well, Charles, we saw a comeback bid fall just a little short, but give them credit. They were able to hold on, withstand that comeback, and ultimately win it by the slim margin.
And bottom line, when it's all said and done, they don't ask you how much you won by. They just want to know, did you win? And that they did.
So for the Panthers, hey, they finish a perfect month of September as they move to 4-0 on the new campaign. And they'll get to stay home again next week. Meanwhile, for Chicago, they'll drop down to 1-3. And they'll try to get back to their winning ways next week as they head to Lambeau to take on the Packers. So for our entire crew, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.
Going big, going big. Everywhere I go, they know the shit. Way too many when they know the shit. They was hating, know they shit. She want bring the limes in. She wanna pull up to the crib, we can't dine in. Up right away, couldn't even get a vine in. Straight with the money, we aligned in. Tell me how they broke, tryna chime in. Jesus watching over here in diamonds. He the only reason why I do not get violent. Ay, cause he gave me patience. Ay, swear the shit don't make sense. Ay, when you making bands, can make friends. Cause I know they tryna shit like Ray Bans. Got a bad little shorty wasting. And I own it, I ain't gotta pay rent. Ay, I know we the ones that ain't them. Pull both hands together and I'm saying amen. Cause I'm going big, going big. Everywhere I go, they know the click. Way too many wins, they know the shit. They was hating, know they sick. Acting like they know me. Cause I'm going big, going big. Going bigger, Postmates, how I deliver. My game too cold, made it shiver. But I'm still a hot boy, cool down, let it simmer. Hey, see him mad, got him bitter. Can't stop the shine with a dimmer. Only what I give her, and she love to call me baby, but I do not need a sitter. See me dip, yeah, I'm saucing. People at the bank see me often. Let the money run, it's a faucet. She gave me the that's a faucet. Took over the game, now we all in. Make my mama stop working, that's the promise. Going big. Everywhere I go, they know the click. Way too many wins, they know the shit. They was hating, know they sick. Acting like they know me, cause I'm going big. Everywhere I go, they know the click. Way too many wins, they know the shit. They was hating, know they sick. Acting like they know me, cause I'm
P-P-P-Love, time to bring the bass back.